Alright, we're back for round two. Or round three.
Yeah, our final round. And this hand is fantastic.
Yep, we're on the draw, but this hand's still great. Sign and Blood's a little awkward on the draw. Hopefully they just, like, give us a Crippling Blight target on turn one.
I wish for Elvis Mystic.
So far, all of Jacob's wishes have come true, so... right. No Fugitive Wizards today, I guess.
You can just loot. That's fine.
Yeah, it's not bad, especially in a deck like ours where we want to draw a mix of threats and answers. Crippling Blight's also probably just not good against the blue deck most of the time.
Ooh, Mind Sculpt.
Oh my. Alright.
Oh my god. We're probably not very good against a Mind Sculpt deck. We're going to have to board up to a lot of cards.
I think
we
definitely want to loot then.
Yeah.
Just get some pressure going, because like our traditional removal's not even going to be good.
Alright.
Rotfeaster Maggot's great. Would you like to discard a Swamp, you think?
Yes.
I agree. We can also board in Unmake the Graves or whatever that card's called.
Yeah, that card's good.
The double Disentomb.
Ooh, Rune Call Bear.
Alright, a little bit of half and half. A little damage, a little milling.
It's a 1-2 punch I haven't encountered before. What do you want to do to this bear?
Probably nothing. I don't really care about it, do you? The only thing, it feels like he could convoke something, but otherwise I don't think we care.
Alright, I guess he can have the bear. I mean,
we could Lightning Strike it.
I'd be okay stabbing it.
Stabbing it? Really? Don't we want to stab a 3-3?
Yeah, but then if we stab a 3-3, then we can never attack.
Alright, fine. We'll Lightning Strike, or we'll stab it, I guess.
I mean, we might regret this in the future, but...
we have a lot of removal left in our deck and hand.
We could also just have taken the damage, I guess. Like,
the main reason I wanted to do that is so that we could cast Sign and Blood next turn and not have to discard. But we'll see what happens.
What is this?
Well,
Paragon?
It's kind of good that we killed that thing then. Yeah, it's the green Paragon. So
wait. Just play
I wanted to play Sign of Blood and Lightning Strike this turn.
I wanted to play Witches.
Alright, that's fine too.
I don't really think we need to Sign of Blood.
Yeah, that's fair. It's not not strictly necessary. They just would use all of our mana this turn. That's the only reason I wanted to do it.
Yeah, I just don't really want to Lightning Strike that guy. Just yet.
I think we're going to end up doing it anyway. Does it gives green creatures Trample?
Probably.
Yeah, okay. Whatever. I'm just gonna Rot Feaster.
Yep. Hopefully it's something good in the graveyard.
We have a Nightfire Giant. That's our biggest
tree.
Our biggest man.
Fortunately we don't have the
Should we attack? I guess we could have attacked first.
Yeah, attack.
Yeah. We should have definitely attacked first, but if he has a trick, we're pretty happy that he uses it on the frog anyway, I think.
Indeed. Also, it'd be weird to play Combat Tricks and Mind Sculpt in the same deck.
Well, once the first Mind Sculpt is played, I'd say all bets are off.
Reasonable. What's this? Wall of Frost?
Alright. That's a good Crippling Blight target, I suppose.
How much mana do we have? We have six.
We can just play Crippling Blight and Spirit this
turn.
Yeah,
that's what I want to do. Okay. I know that you want to keep casting the sign, but we keep drawing a creature whenever you want to cast the sign.
I just want to draw cards.
I want to wait to draw cards until we have no cards in hand.
Alright. I'm just a simple man of simple pleasures.
This game's going very well.
I agree. Ooh, how do we make that? How come this one has little blue arrows around it and this one doesn't?
It's not quite as powerful.
Oh, this one, it's because this one exiled that thing over there.
Oh, okay. It's Lincoln.
So that we know why the Nightfire Giant was exiled. That's kind of strange.
You know, another thing, another use for Sign of Blood and Lightning Strike
is
face.
Stealing five. That's a good point. I didn't forget, but...
Never forget.
I was not considering that we might want to be Sign of Blooding to deal the last couple points.
That's the real reason I've been telling you not to do it.
You're a genius. I mean, we have him dead if he just doesn't block.
Quite possibly he just doesn't block. Then we dome him.
Alright, I approve. Gotta get your homework started early. Yeah, all right.
Face.
Upstairs. Should we sign in blood first just to live dangerously?
Sure.
Nah, that ain't me.
All right. You gotta live a little sometimes. Just see. What's the worst that could happen?
He could draw a counterspell.
Yeah. And he's still dead.
Yeah, probably.
Got him good.
All right, we got him. That was great. So, do we want a sideboard like he's an all mind sculpt all the time kind of deck, or?
I feel like we can afford to. We have a lot of good cards.
I mean, this Forge Devil looks horrible against blue green. There's like no X1s in either color except for Seder Wayfinder, and.
I don't wish Mystic would be hazard.
Sure, but like we still I wanted to board in Crippling Blight anyway, so okay. Like because it's good against Wall of Frost.
Sure.
And then board in Unmake the Graves and just play 41 cards.
I want to play more. Zopshade's good. Kurt Chieftain's good.
Kurt Chieftain's not going to be good.
Paragon is good.
Alright, and then add like two lands. Add a swamp and a mountain.
Yeah.
Did it add? Yeah, it did. Okay, cool. Alright, yeah. That seems good. That's like we've added a whole Mind Sculpt to our deck. We could bring Inferno Fist too.
Sure. That kills multiple of his creatures. We can cut the.
Nah, too late.